Hi, welcome to Savi's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. In our previous class, we had seen how to use the right and left compensating presser feet with our industrial sewing machines. In this class, let's see few more interesting and useful presser feet for the industrial sewing machines. If you see in a well-made ready garment, the stitches are very neat and uniform. That's because the garment manufacturing industries use specialized machines, attachment or presser feet for specific jobs. Though we cannot have different machines, we can definitely have different attachments and presser feet for home sewing. These special presser feet and attachments not just make our work easier, they also make it much neater and faster. So in this class, let's see how to use the loop folder presser feet and the elastic shearing foot. Let's start. First, let's see how to use this loop folding foot. The part number of this foot is F515 and the size of the foot is mentioned here, that is 1/4 inch. We also have 1/8 of an inch. Now what this 1/4 inch means is the ready loop will be 1/4 inch wide, and to get a ready loop of 1/4 inch width, the fabric strip you need to insert is 1 inch. The fabric strip can be bias or straight. So if you measure the opening here, it is exactly 1 inch. So you need to insert 1 inch wide fabric and it has to go all the way here and come out of this. Let me show. Now here I'm using a ready satin ribbon which is 1 inch wide. You can use a ready tape or you can cut from the fabric, and the wrong side of the ribbon is towards my left because this is how it will be folding. So you want the right side to show on top. See, it's come here. Keep pushing till it comes out from here. If you find it difficult to push, you can use a needle or something to push the fabric. Now you see it's already folded and ready. Now you install the foot. Installing the presser foot is same as we install any other presser foot in industrial sewing machine. So you loosen the screw here, you insert the presser foot and tighten, and make sure you tighten with a screwdriver so that it does not come off as you're sewing. Now in my previous video which shows on the screen, I had mentioned that whenever you're using a presser foot which did not come with the machine, you always should check the alignment. That is, when you lower the needle, it should not touch any part of the presser foot. It should be correctly aligned. If it is not aligned, you need to do some changes which I had shown in my previous video. Please refer to that if you have not yet seen. This is important because if the needle hits the presser foot and if you continue sewing, it can break the needle or it can also damage the presser foot. So check all that and then start with the sewing. So we don't have to do anything here. It will automatically form the loop. So you see here the loop is easily formed, that is, folds on either side of the fabric strip and also it folds in the center and then stitches to the edge here. I'll just cut this off. Now you can use these loops as drawstrings in your skirts or pants. You can use it as decorative trims in your garment, and it can be used in various projects. So this is how you make it. Now there is another way where you can directly stick this to a fabric. That is, if you want to stick this loop onto the fabric, for example, if you want to sew this trim to a skirt, you can place the skirt fabric below and then directly sew it. So in this case, you don't have to worry about the loop. You just have to manage the fabric here. So simultaneously, it has made a loop and also stitched to the fabric. Let me show on the wrong side. So this is how it is. Let's quickly see 1/8 inch folder also. In this folder, the insertion is on the right hand side. So the fabric strip width should be 1/2 inch. That is, if you measure here, you will see that needs 1/2 inch. Now inserting the fabric is the same way like we had seen in the previous foot. So this created a 1/8 inch wide loop. This can be used as a dory or it can be used as a trim on your garment. If you were to do this manually, you would have to fold on either side and then fold in the center, which would be very time consuming, and also you may not get it as uniform as it is in this foot. So this saves a lot of time when you have to do something like this. Next foot I'll show is the elastic shearing foot. The part number is S537, and again there are different sizes available in this. The size we have here is 1/8 and 1/4 inch. This is used to sew elastic onto the fabric, or you can also use a tape. The elastic or tape needs to be inserted here and it has to come out of here. Now this is the size mentioned on the foot. So 1/8 inch is this distance here. So you can insert tape which is 1/8 inch wide or a elastic which is 1/8 inch wide. So let's see, using the tape we just made, let's see how to stitch this to the fabric. Let me change the presser foot. You can also first insert the presser foot and then install the presser foot, or you can insert the tape now. So the tape width should be the size mentioned on the presser foot. Insert it till it comes out from below and pull a 1/2 inch tail, and then we can sew it. Right side of the tape should be on top. You can use any ready tape of this width. Now we'll see how to sew it to the fabric. Just put the fabric under the presser foot and see where you want to stitch it. So this is how you do it. So this foot is for 1/8 inch tape or elastic. I don't have a 1/8 inch elastic, so I'm using this elastic cord. Let's see how this works. So insert it till it comes out from the bottom and pull a tail and then stitch. Now for when you're using elastic, you will need to tighten the spring. There is a screw here. You need to tighten this to create tension so that you get gathers in the fabric. For tape, we did not do that. But for elastic, you need to tighten. And the more you tighten, the more gathered the fabric will be, because the elastic stretches more. So let me tighten this. And then you don't have to do anything. You just make sure the needle is sewing in a straight line or wherever you want. Now to pull the elastic, you may have to loosen it a little so that it comes off easily. So this is how it is. Depending on your design, you can stitch multiple rows of this elastic. Now I've sewn this on the wrong side of the fabric. On the right side, this is how it shows. Now the white thread shows because that is the thread color used in the bobbin. If you don't want the thread to show, you will need to use the fabric color thread in the bobbin while stitching. I'll quickly show the 1/4 inch foot also. So I've changed to a 1/4 inch foot, and this is the 1/4 inch elastic. So push the elastic till it comes out, or insert the elastic and then insert the presser foot. I'm again sewing on the wrong side. I've not changed the thread, but ideally when you're sewing on your garment, use a matching thread so that it looks neat. Tighten the screw more to get more gathers. So this is how it looks. So this is how it looks on the right side. It can be done at the sleeve open or at the waist and different sewing projects. In the next video, let's see some more of the presser feet for industrial sewing machine. For example, there is roller feet, invisible zipper foot, hammer foot, and quilting foot, and many more. Thanks for watching this class, and happy sewing!